What's up, y'all? Sparky here, and I want to do a versus video between the LG V20 and the Samsung Galaxy Note 5. Now, these are the best of the best as far as what LG and Samsung have to offer. And by best of the best, I mean their phablets, their big boy phones, not their consumer phones. Even the Galaxy S7 Edge is more of a consumer phone than the Note 7 was. And the V20 is definitely not a consumer phone. It's more of a power user phone. So I'm going to get into what I like and dislike about each one of these phones and everything that has to entail with a versus video. Now, off the bat, the LG V20 overall feels better in the hand to me. It stays cooler more consistently, mainly because it has this metal construction. Not saying that the Note 5 feels like crap. It doesn't. But it feels very slimy due to the glass construction. And as you guys can see, it's quite the fingerprint magnet. But on the LG V20, you have your 16 megapixel f1.8 aperture camera that records up to 4K at 30 frames per second. Or if you don't want 4K, you could go up to 1080p 60 frames per second. You have your 8 megapixel wide angle f2.0 aperture, or 2.1. It's always kind of hard for me to remember. Aperture camera lens that I believe also records up to 1080 60. It might record up to 1080 30. I don't know. But I've never really used the wide angle lens for recording video, aside from like going into wide angle for certain shots. Because I tend to record video at night if I'm out, never during the day. You have your dual LED flash, and you have your laser autofocus and your color depth sensor. You have your fingerprint scanner on the back that doubles as the power button as well. Well, give me one quick minute. I'm just downloading another game real quick on the Note 5, but I'm going to keep going with the V20 here real quick. I already did the back. On the bottom, you have your speaker grill, your USB Type-C charging port / data connector. You have your noise-canceling microphone, and you have your 3.5 millimeter headphone jack with its hi-fi quad DAC. On the top, you have your other noise-canceling microphone, and you have your IR blaster. On the front, you have your 5 megapixel wide angle lens that could also be cropped so that you could do just a regular normal focal length picture. I'll show you guys real quick. Now, I know I do this in every video, but I just want to show you guys what I mean. You press that on the right, and it'll bring you wider, which honestly doesn't really do much, but it's cool nonetheless for them to actually keep doing that without having two different cameras like they did on the LG V10. Now on the front, you have your proximity sensor, which you cover up, it'll turn off the second display. You have your quad HD 5.7 inch IPS LCD quantum display. Your LG branding on the bottom right there. On the bottom right here is polycarbonate. On the top here is also polycarbonate, which is for drop protection as well as antennas so that you can actually get reception. And what else? You have your 3,200 milliamp hour removable battery with your SIM card slot, which is a nano SIM, micro SIM, as well as your micro SD card slot. And as you guys see here, this is actual aluminum. This isn't nothing fake. This isn't what the G5 pulled. And the side rails are aluminum. And as you guys can see, there's a kind of curvature to the overall design of the V20. Where it has that little dip right there. And it also has that on the other side too. And it makes it so it actually feels comfortable to put to your face as well, without the phone having to be curved, kind of like the G4 is. All right, that's the V20. Now let me talk about the Galaxy Note 5. I was really about to say S7. You have your 16 megapixel f1.8 aperture camera that shoots up to 4K, or if you don't like 4K, 1080p, 60 frames per second. You have your heart rate sensor and your LED flash. You have your Note branding right there. On the bottom, aluminum railing all around. You have your 3.5 millimeter headphone jack. You have your micro USB charging cable / data transfer cable port. Port. You have your speaker grill and you have your noise canceling microphone as well as your S Pen silo that houses the S Pen. Obviously, you have your four, antenna cutouts so that you can actually get reception. As far as which one does reception better, which one does antenna lines better, LG has always been pretty much the best when it came to hiding antenna lines, especially when you compare it to like Apple phones. Why did I say Apple phones? iPhones. Well, technically they are Apple phones. So, the light is really making it hard for my G4 to focus. You have your SIM card slot right here. You have your other noise canceling mic up there, no IR blaster. You have your glass back in the ever so beautiful, in my opinion, probably the best looking color Samsung has made, the black sapphire. I like this color a lot. On the front, you have your 5.7 inch Super AMOLED display. You have your fingerprint scanner down here with your Samsung branding on top, your 5-megapixel wide-angle camera, your two proximity sensors, and your LED notification light. You have two capacitive buttons that flank, I guess you can say that flank the fingerprint / home button. You hold it, and you actually got to press the home button to activate the fingerprint scanner, while on the V20, you can just touch it and it'll activate. So as far as hardware differences, as I said, I prefer the feel of the V20 because it feels more cool to the touch when I pick it up. Whereas this feels a bit warm. It does get cold. It gets really cold when you don't use it for a bit, but I use my Note 5 quite a bit. All right, and as far as like the screen brightness test goes, let's do that live here. I already know the Note 5 is gonna win out, but as far as what you see, What I personally think is that I personally feel that the brighter the screen gets, the more not eye pleasing it is to actually look at the phone screen. So me personally, while the V20 doesn't get as bright or whatever, at least I could still look directly at the display and not have like eye strain, because I do wear glasses and it kind of hurts when I'm looking at a screen at its full brightness. Now, I never have screens at full brightness, but I'm gonna show you guys something real quick. When you turn auto brightness on the LG V20, what happens is that the screen actually does get way brighter. It's kind of hard to do with like LED flash. You actually have to be in like a super lit area. But give me a second real quick. Not super lit, I meant well lit. Like, it has to be like during the day that, you know, it's the sun is blaring outside. That's when you have the auto brightness on, and it'll serve you well. It really will on the V20. No, I don't have anything. I don't have anything on the home screen, any widgets or anything, because I just switched to the Pixel Launcher on my Note 5. But what I'm going to do here is I'm just going to scroll through here on both without activating anything. They both are pretty smooth as far as that goes. But what I'm going to do here is I'm going to open some apps. And how I normally do it, I'm going to just do it separately so that it's easier to do. I didn't even open anything on there. It's kind of hard to do when I'm looking at the camera viewfinder. Now let me do the same on here. Since I have apps in the dock, I may as well do that. As you guys can see, it actually loads stuff up a bit slower. Not to the point where it's like the Note 5 is a shit phone to use. It actually feels very like quick and responsive, no lie. But what I'm gonna do is what I normally do, and I'm gonna open up some games here. First let me actually boot it up on the Note 5 here so I can actually do the test the same way. All right, now I'm gonna boot them up at the same time. I'm gonna let it load up. Have the title screen come up. What? Okay, so that was actually pretty interesting. The Note 5 opened got to the title screen and the save point screen faster. But the V20 loaded the overall game faster. So however you guys feel about that, there's kind of apples and oranges there, you know? There's no really, like, true definite winner in that case. But the Note 5 has the Exynos 7420, which is an octa-core chip, which is Samsung's very own chip. So it's kind of easier for them to optimize it so that it works great. And I think last year Samsung hit it out of the park with their chip. The only problem is battery optimization, which is still the case even with the Galaxy S7 and S7 Edge. So I'm going to just kill this kill this bastard over here real quick. Then I'm gonna kill this one. Yeah, this is a Legend of Zelda-like game. Which is why I like it. I really like Legend of Zelda a lot. So that's how it played on the Note 5. And it played really smooth, too. It didn't feel, like, boggish or anything like that. So, do the same on here. Ah, fuck. I hate it when that happens. Come back here, you generic-ass Octorok. Right. Whoop that one's ass. And that's pretty much it. Now let's load up Sonic Dash here. Which I know I have on both phones. So I'm going to do that real quick. That's weird. So for some reason, on the Note 5, whenever I load a game up, another one crashes. I don't know why that is, but I'm gonna start these games here real quick. It loaded faster on the V20 there. But they both play really smooth. Oh, fuck, I missed a red ring. Oh, well. I have over 30 of them. I'm not really going to pay attention, really. I'm just going to let it ride for the most part. So, honestly, I really don't care. Besides, sticking on a straight path will normally get me a lot of rings. It closes faster on the V20 with the software buttons. So that pretty much destroys the myth that hardware buttons are fast, actually aid the phone in closing apps faster. As you guys clearly saw, it really doesn't. Let me load a couple more apps up on here. I'll load up another game, why not? Now these both have 4 gigs of RAM, but in my experience, the V20 is better at RAM management. There we go. Let me make sure I didn't close them. Okay. Now I'm going to go to the settings real quick. Sorry, I'm kind of used to Android 7. I'm kind of used to Nougat. What I'm going to do first is I'm going to show you guys the software version of each phone. And show you guys the... You guys with security updates they're on and all that stuff, all that good stuff. Shit. Don't go to software info. Software info. Oh, it actually shows me. So they're both on the December security update. This is on Android 6.0.1. This is on Android 7.0. And even there, as you guys saw me, just exit out them both at pretty much the same time. Soft keys are actually better when it comes to overall exiting out of the app faster. Because it's integrated within the software. So I don't know if that's really a difference, but I just wanted to say that. It sounded smart. I'm just kidding. But What else to talk about? This has 32 gigabytes of internal storage. But out of the box, I think it came out with like 26. Well, I didn't even get it in the box. I got it in like a bag. But how you guys will typically get it out of the box, it came out with maybe like 28 or 26. This came out with 60 out of 64 gigabytes of storage. This has micro SD card expansion. This doesn't, which was one of the gripes that a lot of people had, that if this is a power user phone, why doesn't it have a power user feature at least like, you know, have a micro SD card slot if you're not going to have a removable battery. And I also meant to do the lag test too. I'm sorry. My bad. GPU rendering profile. On screen is bars. GPU. What the fuck is it? It's kind of hard to see with the display so dim. Oh, profile GPU rendering on screen is bars. And even there, as you guys saw, now there's nothing on this screen, so, and even then it still lags out a bit. I'm opening an app. Scroll down it. Now it does have to load a bit, so keep that in mind. I'm gonna do the same on here. Open an app, scroll up, and what the fuck? It doesn't show the damn shit. Now on the overall user interface on the V20, it overall stays under the line. So it stays above that 60 frames per second mark majority of the time. But you guys also have to keep in mind, I have a shit ton of apps open on both of these phones. So frame drops are pretty much evident when you don't have enough RAM to back it up, I guess you can say. It booted me out of dev options. I forget it does that. It does that even when you do have a lot of, even when you don't have a lot of stuff open in the background, so don't worry about that. But, and as you guys can see, the Note 5 did a little bit of a jump. So, and as far as which feels cooler in the hand to hold right now, after all that stuff, the V20 does. Not saying that the Note 5 feels hot or warm, it doesn't. It just, glass doesn't get as naturally cool unless you actually put it in cold. So, in a cold environment. But yeah, as far as these two go, these two series from LG and Samsung are my go-tos from now on from both of these manufacturers. Like, you can say what you want about, you know, LG not having an AMOLED display, Samsung not having a removable battery, stuff like that. But overall, and yes, I do mean overall, these two phones clash similarly. I had the same feeling when I had my V10. The V10 clashed similarly with this. They both came out in the same year. Since I can't get a Note 7, these two clash admirably with each other. They don't feel, one doesn't feel like, you know, faster than the other. One doesn't necessarily feel slower than the other. This is a better phone if you want a better auto camera. This is a better phone if you want more control of your camera. But overall, both phones have really great cameras. Probably my favorite cameras from both of these manufacturers. But as far as, you know, the LG V20 versus the Samsung Galaxy Note 5, to declare a winner, you personally, there really isn't no clear winner. Because between these two, if you want faster updates, go with LG. If you want an arguably better screen, I guess you can say. As I said, I'm not the biggest fan of Super AMOLED. I love OLED for their deep blacks, but I don't like what Samsung does with their saturation. Go with Samsung if you want the Super AMOLED display. The best Super AMOLED display on the market, you go with Samsung. If you want more customization of the overall user interface, go with LG. If you desire the S Pen and productivity features, you know. The Note 5 is for you then. And I do use the S Pen quite a lot. I didn't in this review, in this versus video, because I don't really see a point to. If both of them are meant for, this is content consumption and creation, as well as music consumption. And between these two with music, this obviously would be the better bet. The V20 beats out pretty much, it beats out anything that came out within like last year and this year's, and what has come out this year so far. And I'm pretty sure it's going to beat out even the HTC U and U Play, the U Ultra and U Play, because it has a 3.5mm headphone jack. And people, they value the headphone jack. For them to move away from that is like a big L, in my opinion. Because not a lot of things support USB Type-C when it comes to audio. And you can't just take something out that people have had for decades, Apple, and then try and say that your method is better when it really isn't. It's actually been tested and it's actually a bit worse. Like the iPhone 6S versus the iPhone 7, the headphone quality is a bit worse when you do like that. The EarPods with the Lightning connector and the EarPods with the 3.5mm connector. It's a bit worse. And it will be leagues worse than this. But this is no slouch when it comes to headphone output. It really isn't. It's a really great phone if you want that as well. But I'd say if you value that, if you're an audiophile, you have to go with the V20. It's a given. I don't know why my tripod keeps shifting, but this is the power user. No, this is the average user plus phone, in my opinion. You know, it's beautiful. It feels good in the hand to hold. It doesn't feel too big and overstated. It feels very comfortable. Whereas this is the gargantuan. This is the titan when it comes to big phones, when it comes to phablets. It's huge. It's meant for other stuff. It's not necessarily meant for productivity, even though you have the productivity features. You know? And that's pretty much it. As far as a winner, there is no winner. I love both these phones nearly equally. I won't necessarily say I love them both enough where I can't necessarily decide a winner. Me personally, as a daily driver, it's the V20. But this is a very good companion phone. Both of these complement each other, which is my argument with the V10 last year and the Note 5, is that both of them complement each other. They really do. And that's pretty much all I have to say. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for supporting my channel. Be sure to share these videos with your friends and have them subscribe as well if they want content outside of the norm, outside of the regular 5-minute videos that don't really talk about much. That really just go with the gist of the flow. If they want a more like concise, some more opinionated thing on it, I've had this phone ever since it came out, which is October, November, December, January. It's about to be 5 months with this phone. I've had this phone for over a year. Whereas a lot of reviewers just have to push out reviews within like 2 weeks and stuff like that. And that's not what I'm going to do with these phones. I'm keeping them because I enjoy them. I'm not going against what I feel, you know, because I love both these phones a lot. And I know it's kind of stupid to say, oh, I love this phone, but I do. I paid over $800 for this and paid like over $400 for this. And they both still perform well. Samsung has supported this better than they supported their flagships of last year. And this is about to be 2 years old. But yeah, as far as that goes, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching. As I said, if you're just strolling by my videos, please just subscribe. It doesn't make no sense. And hit that notification bell button on the side of the subscribe button when it comes up after you subscribe so you know when I post videos. I'm not going to post videos every day because I want to have my content sink in for at least 3 to 4 days before I, you know, put another video out. But I'm going to have fairly consistent videos because it doesn't make any sense not to. And another quick thing, I forgot to actually talk about it. Speaker quality. They're pretty much on par. A lot of like LG V20 units when they first came out had like an issue where there's popping. But they released a software patch and it helps. With a lot of different videos I've saw that some videos actually do have the popping. But when I listen to music, it doesn't do that. And a lot of videos don't really do that. It's just more that a lot of videos don't do that. It's just the ones with, I guess, like a bit louder audio than it needs to be, I guess, that does that. But I'm gonna play. It's kind of weird. When I'm actually listening to it through the speaker, I hear more sounds than I normally hear. And I haven't listened to this song in a while, too. But I'm going to play it on here as well. Both of these. I can do this all night.
mastermind. Fuck a bitch to pass the time. Mass appeal, orange rind. Smoke your green, I'm spending mine. The beat is witch's brew. But beware, this shit is poe-e-e-e coming on her face. Now there's poetry in motion. There can be no make it work.
Yeah. As far as that goes, they're pretty much on par, honestly. There's nothing that I'd say that the V20 beats it out. I guess it beats it out in overall, like, quality and overall, like, loudness. But they're all, but they're both pretty much equal as far as that goes. I wanted to do that real quick before I just leave. And I know I make these videos long. Sorry for that, you guys. I just want to let you guys know how I feel about these phones overall. And that I don't get these phones from manufacturers to review, which is why I'm a bit more harsh on them than other reviewers are. Not saying that those reviewers don't have like good reviews, but because they do. I watch them all a lot. But these phones are great for the money. The Note 5 is still a great phone to get. If you want to wait for the next Note, the Note 8 or something, then wait for it. But honestly, I feel that the Note 5 is still a great phone. It's still a great buy. And the V20 is still here and it won't have a refresh till October. So at least that's how it's normally been. So if you want to wait for it, wait for it. But I'd say get the V20. Support LG in their endeavors. Just because there's no, like, you know, marketing does not mean that the phone is trash. I'm going to say that now. But yeah, this is Sparta. Thank you guys for watching. Thank you for supporting my content. If you liked it, do the thumbs up. If you didn't like it, do the thumbs down. But if you are too lazy and don't feel like doing it, don't do it. I don't really care. But as far as this goes, that's pretty much it. Thank you guys for watching and have a good one.